Allah says in Surah Fussilat, وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍّ عَظِيمٍ. Who will be able to receive that or achieve Jannah besides those who are patient? And who will be able to receive or achieve it besides those who have good fortune? Those who are very fortunate, they are the ones who will be given the opportunity to engage in sabr. Allahu Akbar. Let us take a look at what this means. If you are fortunate, you are given an opportunity to engage in sabr. Because through that engaging in sabr, you will then be able to get Jannah. How will you be able to engage in sabr if no hardship came in your life? This is why the most hardships ever were in the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They beat him, they swore him, they mocked at him, they employed sanctions against him for many years. They began to eat leaves of trees because they were hungry, subhanallah. The companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He was made to bleed in Taif. And they prepared armies and went to attack him. They spread rumor about him. They tried to do this and that. Difficulties that are unimagined. Because his status is the highest. Allahu Akbar. So if Allah has tested you with big tests, you must know that He has tested others with even bigger tests. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us that sabr is from Allah. It is Allah who gives you that opportunity to engage in sabr. Look at what He says in Surah An-Nahl. وَاصْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Bear patience. For indeed, that quality of sabr will only come to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from no one else. It is a gift from Allah. Otherwise, others, they will definitely be tested. Everybody will be tested. But we have two groups of people. Those who consider the test as a punishment, and they get depressed, and their life comes to an end. Someone dies, and you die with them. Something happens, something goes missing, and you go missing with them. Which means you are so depressed that your life has come to a standstill. Allah says, if you want to choose that path, you will lose here and you will lose there as well. But Allah says, the other path is to choose our path. To acknowledge that definitely we are in control. It is a gift from us. Patience is a gift, and realize it and recognize it. Now sometimes as human beings, it becomes a little bit difficult. The reason is, we have a heart. We have a brain, we have a mind, we have feelings. And sometimes a person is taken away who is very close to us. It's a little bit difficult. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, has taught us what to do to enhance and increase. To enhance and increase our sabr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, you must read the stories of the prophets that we have mentioned in the Quran. And this instruction was also to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If you want to ease your problems, go and read the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Read his life. Your problems will seem like nothing. Allahu Akbar. You want to ease your difficulties. Allah tells Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, go and read about the difficulties of Ayyub alayhi salam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Sad, He says, Ayyub alayhi salam, may Allah's peace be upon him, the Prophet. He was tested so much, that Allah had to declare that we tested him and we found him to be patient. Allahu Akbar. Imagine the Creator Himself is declaring somebody patient. This is unheard of. Subhanallah. Allah says it in the Quran. Ni'ma al-abd. What a great worshipper is Ayyub. Inna wajadnahu sabira. We tested him in every way you can think of, and we found him to be the most patient, or very, very patient. Allahu Akbar. Ni'ma al-abdu. What a great worshipper. Allahu Akbar. Look at that. Ayyub alayhi salam, I think it's our duty to go out and read his story, because we don't have the time to go into his story now. Look at how Allah gave him and took away from him and then gave him again. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. He passed the test. Allah says, we found him to be patient. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us goodness through his mercy and not test us with tests that will be too difficult for us to pass. Ameen.